Greetings fellow Oathlings, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall as a Mage. Now, I've been inactive for some time and, I had a few emergencies to attend to. One of my friend's cats was missing, so, you know, they got him back now, but, yeah, that happened. And I think these cows are a tad bit short, though. Or maybe I'm just too tall. Yeah, these guys move a lot, don't they? So anyway, we're in front of the Mage's Guild right here. And we have only one singular objective, and that is to complete some quests for them. And hopefully find the location of you-know-what without having to do it the way it's intended. Let it happen organically, essentially. And right off the bat, we can see the quest that the structure of this space is quite similar to one of the previous ones. I think the one in Daggerfall. Oh yeah, by the way, we are in Menevia right now, in case I haven't told you guys yet. It's 16:25 or 4:25, almost 4:30 in the evening. Let's go ahead and save in the pre-quest slot here. So if I can find the location of that place without ever having to, you know, save scum, that's all well and good. But if I can't find the location of that place until the end, then yeah, we're gonna have to do a little bit of safe scumming. There's always an element of RNG to these things. Modester Hoxton. Alright, let's talk to you. Wait, that's not the quester? This guy must be the quester then. Right here. By the dragon, is there anything more exasperating than the discovery that the mummy's wrappings you were planning on using as in a potion have gone all sorts of green? I could use the guild wrapping, but the recipe specifically calls for a superlatively fresh mummy wrapping. Yeah, 4 superlatively fresh mummy wrappings, whatever that means. I don't suppose you'd be willing to scare me up some cloth of a mummy I know has more wrapping than it knows what to do with. Sure, that's why we're here. Jolly good journeyman. It'll be worth 347 gold to you. Now this mummy's tomb is not too far away at all, so it shouldn't take any longer than 5 days to get there, make a grab and get back. Remember, it's got to be fresh, preferably off its body. The name of the place is something like the Crypt of Morivillon. It's sure to be gruesome there. You might want to bring a sword or some such thing. Well, good luck, young brethren. I have my spells. I have no need for swords. Anyhow, let us cast a teleport right here. Set an anchor for when we come back, especially with a very close deadline. I mean, it is just a day travel, but resting inside dungeons can be pretty hectic. Of course, I need to step out nonetheless. Whoops. Yeah, let's go. No, ships don't sail on the sea, so I'll stick to my horse instead. Wait a minute. This thing looks... Wait, did he literally just send us through like a minor dungeon to search for this mummy? That is sort of unacceptable, sir. That is incredibly unacceptable. Crypt of Morivillon. Yeah, this is literally just a minor dungeon. Well, from the outside anyway. That's how those things are structured. But who knows how it'll be once we go inside. So let us see from the dungeon slot right here. Right, here we are. And let's head inside then. Wait, that can't be the mummy, right? Okay, there are lots of mummies here. And the... Okay, I'll probably need to... That is very difficult. This is... Whew. Unfortunately, I'll have to use this. Because my god, that was a challenging fight right off the bat. Let me cast that and that and just save right here, because holy hell, that was a challenge. Right, so off we go. So this place is like infested with mummies from the looks of it, although I don't think the invisibility spell is going to be of any help. I just cast it nonetheless. I can hear more mummies all around the base. It's like This place is like full of mummies. Do these guys like mummify the dead or something? Seems to make the most sense to me, actually. I hear another mummy back there. What's sad is that these guys can actually... At least I'm getting to use the restore spell a lot. So I suppose that's good, in a sense. So perhaps it is time for me to reflect on what I've learned about Critical Strike. Shall I rest here? Do I dare? Sure. I mean, at the end of it all, I'll at least have the spell points to carry myself. Yeah, at least have the spell points to carry myself forward. I keep forgetting to make spells to... Well, not that. Yeah. Fortify my attributes. That's one of the spells that I want to make. Cast a shield there. I don't know how long it's going to last, but it just cast it nonetheless. It's pretty expensive, the shield spell, I mean. Ooh, alteration level up. Just because I cast that spell, I suppose. Ah, mummy. Hey, mummy. How is you? Well, you start now. Now, the problem with these quests is how you can see so many of these monsters inside these dungeons that are, you know, that are perfectly fine to be used. Like, whose wrappings I can use without any issues. But still, the game will make me... What the fuck just happened? Did the spell just... Did the spell literally just... Gold pieces in all the water. Yeah, the spell literally phased through the walls there. I hear skellies. Alright, since I already placed a bead down there, let me just go ahead and make sure that it's placed properly. Now let me destroy it. Yeah. Right up there. Good. Alright, let's go here. This way. Let me go and save here. It's strange, like after I save sometimes the game just decides to update the lighting. Fireball is probably the best spell that anybody can ask for. I think I hear skellies there. Come on, open the door up. Oh, nothing here? Alright. I guess the skellies must be on the other side then. Wherever they are coming closer, huh? I can hear that much. Unless there's like a hidden door along the side of the wall there, there isn't. Thought I could hear them right next to me, but apparently not. Must have been my imagination. Must have been the wind, as they say in Skyrim. Ah, just a rat. Do I really want to? Let's just poison you and leave you be. Right then. Whoops, did not mean to do that. So that side of the dungeon has been explored. I keep hearing all of these creatures down here. I mean, that's sort of what you should be expecting when getting into one of these dungeons. But yeah, it still makes me nervous. And that's just one of the ways that Daggerfall has been made so well. Like, look at me clearing corners as if it's a tactical shooter. I don't know what good my invisibility spell does me right now, but I cast it nonetheless. There you go. I was wondering when you'd notice me. A steel katana. Not that I need one. This is a tough dungeon. This is a very difficult dungeon. Well, I honestly wouldn't say very difficult, but it is difficult nonetheless. Religious item and a belt. So we are searching for a mummy, like a very specific mummy. Not just any mummy won't do. It needs to be a very specific one. The one that we're looking for. I mean, holy shit. I'm not getting any respite. I think I'll need to begin resting once more. Fuck you. Alright, that's what's happening. We're gonna close the store and we're gonna rest. I just cast some spells just in case. Actually, let's just save right here. Alright, let us trudge onwards. Onwards and to darkness. Now, where do we go from here? Choices, choices. People make choices when they're sick. If you can recognize those lyrics, good on you. Okay, more choices to make. Yeah, let's take a ride here and let's check out whatever this. Oh no, it's that module. Of course, it just had to be. I honestly just did that to level up my what options do I have here? I've got that option right in front of me, and of course, like, I do believe there's an option to my left here. I'll just place that there and let us make a U-turn. Actually, we can't. There's a path to my left that I can check out though, so I guess we're going there then. As decreed by the Elder Scrolls. I thoroughly dislike this module, I mean. Okay, since we have found a hidden door here. Yeah. This module is like super confusing. It just adds like needless depth to a dungeon. Yeah, let's just head straight for now. Let's see where that takes us. Looks like something got packed. It was a rat, apparently. Okay, even more choices for us to make. Right. Why is this dungeon so large? I was wondering where you are, sir. Turns out you're right there. That was good. Like, didn't even have to be on him to destroy him, I mean. Yeah, let me just take on this curtain as well and then we can destroy the rest of them together. I see you, mummy. I see you. I see you. Holy tome and an elven short sword, which I can definitely use. Alright, let's rest here. Stealth alteration blunt weapon. Right. I'm gonna save in a new slot here. I feel like these spells are sort of unnecessary for this dungeon, but I'm just gonna spam them one more time. Like the two spells that I have constantly been spamming. And see where it goes from there. There you are. I was trying to get across the skeleton. But then the game wouldn't let me. I hear many more of them upstairs. I don't know why there are so many skeletons up there, but my god. Huh, only one path forward. Let's take it then. The thing that sucks the most about these places is the fact that they tend to lead to dead ends like this, which are like a huge waste of time. If only they had something like, you know, look at all of those things screaming for you. They can detect you through walls. My god. Yeah, given all the enemies in this level, I feel like alright, we headed the other way then. Yeah, I was seeing something, I sort of forgot what I was about to say. A current of air blows past you. That's typically something that that's reserved for the exits, isn't it? Three blasts to the face, and that's what it took to down you. Nothing here either. Typically there isn't any hidden door or anything of that nature down here. Alright, so we have covered both sides then. Unless there are some hidden doors along the walls there, not really. Not that I can tell. Alright, so down the stairs we go then. I was beginning to get fatigued by choice anxiety. Good to see that that phase of the game has passed at least. And good to know that we have set a recall anchor so that we don't exactly need to teleport back out of here. How many spells do you take, son? Potion of Water Walking. Could be useful, not that I need it, but it could definitely be useful, yes. Oh, another one of you. Now that I know your weakness, it's quite easy to like deal with you. There's a rock on that. That's the first time I've seen such a structure. Holy relic, holy tome. Religious item and an icon. The question is, do I want to travel on this elevator? Well, you know what? I'll just place a marker right here. Whoops, that's not how I do it. Yeah, that way. And we're gonna continue a more traditional exploration of the dungeon. I've heard that as your skill levels up, now question is, do you really want to go up there then? Sure, I don't see why it might hurt. It might hurt, actually. I was thinking of about this save. I haven't really made the save for this character yet, so yeah, I'm gonna save it into. So yeah, I thought I'll save it under emergency, and that is exactly what I did. I hear more skellies there. Hi there. Why are you so resilient, sir? Thank you. That was quite nice of you. Wraith's Essence, Verbo's Tusk, Scarab. There's a small statue there, but they don't really fetch me a lot, so I'm not really gonna carry it with me. It's strange, this entire, you know. Okay, I've got no idea where we stepped out right now. And there seem to be two paths forward. There's also that door over there. So I feel like we have been to a similar place before. Excuse me there. Nothing here, just a room. Alright, time to make a choice. Should we head left or should we head right? Let us begin by heading right instead. Yeah, this way. Anybody behind this door? Oh, it's another way down. So I guess we'll leave this for later exploration as well. Yeah, so that's one of the downsides of leaving invisibility off, is that you'll get molested by creatures lesser than you. Really? Really, son? Come here. That only levels up my destruction. I actually haven't used Jomama in a long while. So maybe I could go and try using that. Let me just save here again. Right. Excuse me. I haven't really used Jomama or Glacial Aura in a long time. Holy shit. Well, that guy fell. I can hear more of them back there. But I suppose I'll just stick to this. I can hear one more skeleton in there, which is crazy. Just crazy. Let me go ahead and save you. Update the save. Oh, it was one of these structures. I see. I see. That's good to know. It said spell was absorbed and that I do not have the spell points to cast it anymore. But that is untrue, isn't it? It's amazing to see just how easy it becomes to. Freshly drawn map indicates the long lost location of Casual Ashley, which you copy down. Right then. Alright. We have got more skeletons that need killing right here. And the spell points to cast that. Typically a room like this might hold what you're looking for, but yeah, it's an if, not really a given. Ooh, skeleton warrior died. How interesting. How quaint. I hear the door open. It's amazing how we can like tackle them easily now. Then again, I'm not really... So this thing, all it does is just unlocks a door for you. That's all it does. Quite literally. And nothing else. So one of these typically has like a hidden room behind it. But it would seem to not have it in this case. Typically there's like a hidden door there, which can be opened by just clicking on it. Yeah, nothing here. Just a whole bunch of skeletons. And I'm surprised at myself that I could actually take this challenge on and survive it. Now all of these noises in the background that are built into the soundtrack sort of... Ah yes, as soon as you touch the loot, the door closes. Like, this is how it's supposed to go. Like, as soon as you touch, like, loot, right? Or try to touch loot from, like, a far away distance. This door is supposed to close, the rest of the doors are supposed to open all of a sudden. And you get trapped in an ambush, but I've actually never really seen it working that way. And the way to get out of here is by triggering that lever. Which didn't really change anything else from the looks of it. That in turn unlocks this door and then you can exit. Typically that's how it's supposed to go. Alright, updating the save since I was victorious. Right. Alright, heading to the opposite direction then. My god, look at all these guys. Just laid out like that. Two dead rats. And there's still the matter of the other side then. I did place a beat down there, didn't I? Yeah. Let us take it off and let us trudge onwards. Seemingly, my shield spell is holding up for quite a long time, so I would take that as a good sign. Of course, this is just another alternative path through the section. Glitched out of bounds for a second there. Yeah, I was like, wait, who opened that door? Then I realized that's probably just... Wait, why are there... Oh, I can't carry any more gold, I see. I can hear skellies, I don't know where they are, but I can certainly hear them. We're slowly reaching a point where we do not really need to rely on our melee weapons anymore. Which is... just the way I like to keep things. Alright, let me go ahead and save here because this area is freaking me out. Just one of the ways that they have succeeded in designing Daggerfall. It creeps you out like anything, does it not? Knock spell is about to die. Oh, we can't carry any more loot, right? Actually, let me just go ahead and drop like a whole bunch of religious icons and stuff that I don't really need. Can I use this? I don't think I can. Right. Let's just go to drop them. Because they take up a lot of needless space in our inventory. So, I mostly pick them up for role-playing reasons, but I can see how that is like super impractical, so we might as well just drop them. And now, we can get more gold from these guys. Now it makes me wonder, where is this damn skeleton that I can hear braying all over the place? Seemingly another mummy behind this door, but... nope, just a rat. Poor thing died when my fireball exploded right here. Alright. We're opening this door. That is just a bat. Hi. You're dead. Nothing here, except for perhaps some skeletons. Let us go ahead and save here. Unless, yeah, let's update this log. Alright, two paths here. We're gonna check out the path right in front of us first. Of course, we're gonna clear our corners. Looks like there's not much here, so we can successfully just remove that safety. Sounds like there are people all over to my left and right. I'll come back for that door. I was looking for you. There's like this door right here. Let me just go ahead and put a bead up there. Because I'll be returning to it, but until then... Hello, Mora maybe? Why not? Of course, spell attack failed. What the fuck, dude? What the fuck, you little bitch? So yeah, these things can be avoided by using the... let's just put a bead up there as well and take this bead right off. Right, that's where we're headed. To the left then. A lot of these dungeons have non-linear parts which... That took a lot of spells. That took a lot of tries, really. I don't know who's smiting who or who's rather trying to smite who, but that was nice. That was nice. Okay, we are in the prison module right here. And we are running low on spell points right now. But the place felt silent all of a sudden, which is sort of... Ah, there we go. Oh, fuck. Did not expect that guy to just pop out of there as soon as he opened the door. My god. Let's just rest here. Why not? Alright. This and this and save. Save too. Right. I doubt there's anything in here except for a bugbear, a dead bugbear at that. And somebody opened something. I don't know what that was, but somebody opened, definitely opened something. Let's just keep heading straight for now. Fuck you. You know what? Let's do this. Yeah, right. Receiving it. If only my spell absorption worked better, I could probably take care of those guys even better. I just want to quickly check out if this place is dead end. This place is actually a dead end, so we can just ignore it for the time being. Right then. Yeah, let me go and remove that bead from there because we have covered it already. And there's nothing here either. Alright. Or is there? Actually, there isn't. No windows or anything of that nature. Right. We are going in. I'm glad that I don't have to figure out my way further from this. Holy shit. How come you be there, sir? I just wish more of my spells had like a... spell absorption thing? Have I been here before? No, I have not. This is like the level right below us. Actually, I'll place that bead there. Just to, you know, because I feel like there might be another one of those ambush rooms up here. Or not. Or not. Actually, let us go check out the other side then. Why not? I'll place it here. And let us remove that. Unless that also takes us downstairs. No, it seems to be a room of sorts. Fuck you, you little bitch. You bit me. Alright, rest. You are currently unwell either due to disease or poisoning. Resting right now may lead you to an early grave. Ha. Thank God for that saving message. What do I have? I'm healthy. They don't show up immediately, these diseases. Like, it takes time for the symptoms to show up, essentially. Alright, so where did it go again? Not divine insight, but right, snake oil. Yes, here we go. Spell it failed both times. Alright, let's try it again. Not spectral change, that's invisibility. Snake oil. Spell it failed, but one of them succeeded. Yep, we can rest now. Alright, we are going to save right here in a fresh slot. And we are going to go back out and adventure even further. I honestly have no idea where I'm headed. Just the fact that I am headed somewhere. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Alright, so we can probably mark this place as having been covered, except for this door to the right. So let us go and check that door out. Flies buzz around me. Because why would they not? Alright, so where are we headed then? Let us place a bead right here because I don't know where that door goes. It might not lead anywhere inconsequential, but you never know. Sort of overkill for that little rat, but whatever. Since I've got like the magic gutter spare, might as well. Typically these modules don't really have anything, so yeah. This is a somewhat more familiar module for me. I should honestly just keep saving every now and then. I was trying to open this door, but my character just kept shooting through. There's like a minimum threshold for casting this spell. So where am I coming out here? No idea, it's like a whole new part of the dungeon. We have never been here before. And why do these things float like that? Nothing here? Seriously? It's a dead end? Alright, if you insist. I guess we can take this opportunity to explore the other side then. Excuse me, Dev. I hear rats in the walls. Which is, to be honest, the strangest place you can ever hear rats, but yeah, I hear them in the walls. Right then, getting rid of that one. We have explored that side as well, so getting rid of that one. This game becomes a greater pleasure to play with every dungeon that you've explored. Yeah, that was I meant to use like Shoe Mama on him. I wasn't sure whether I had selected it or not, and turns out I had actually selected it. He died because I gave him like a very big burn. Poor guy got burned, essentially. Since we're invisible, might as well save our mana. Okay, just another one of these. It was fun to climb on top of that little guy. And not in that sense. I can still hear a skelly, but you never really know where they are. Apparently, these modules have... We have traveled up that elevator as well, so why don't we just head back up then and clear out the rest of these sides that we have not covered yet. Right then. There definitely are skellies to my left, because that side is on also yet unexplored. And then there's that entire maze-like structure which might lead to the objective. Might also not do that. Was I think I was supposed to take this left here? Yes, indeed I was. That is indeed where we came out, and I don't recall having covered all sections here. Yes, I did. See, that's why placing those beads down actually helps. You get to know which areas you've covered and which areas you haven't. So, first let's get back up here and cover this section right there. This part. In order to get back up there, I'll need to go down the stairs, and then, yeah, it's a straight path from there, essentially. Take a left. No, wait, what? Well, we essentially need to head left, right? We need to head left, and that's a straight path from there. I also like the fact that I passed the region Magicka. I think we're supposed to take a right here. Yeah. I hear a skelly right in front of me. Not that I have the spell points to do anything to it, but I do hear it right in front of me. And it is at this point that I would save the game once again. In a new slot, of course. For when the Unity crashes to ruin my day, essentially. Have I been here before? Why is this room still, like, wide ajar? I feel like the skelly or the mummy that came down actually came down from here. Like it sought me out, essentially. I was trying to like open the door and switch back quickly, but the game wouldn't let me. And I had my panties all up in a bunch, trying to do that. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. Okay. Alright, I see which module this is. was wondering when something like that would come out, so I tend to pause in front of the doors for a bit just to see if something comes out or not, and something did in fact come out. This seems like a rest area, so I'll just go and explore this. Or maybe it's not. Oh yes, it is. Oh no, it's one of those rooms that you don't really want to be in. This area I'm quite certain has nothing, so we'll go ahead and remove this weed from here, and we'll remove this weed because there's only really one path for us to take. So let me go and save again, in case the energy crashes, you know, you never know. Alright, we're back. You just had to dodge my attack, didn't you? My Nox is fizzing out. I hear more skellies around. I'm glad to see that Prime Shield actually managed to protect me from a lot of that. I should rest to learn what I've learned about dodging, apparently. Reflect on what I've learned about dodging. Not learn what I've learned about dodging, but yeah, you get the point. Alright, Nox. Whoops. Yeah. With a game this high poly, the staff sort of looks out of place because of how low poly it is. Alright, both of these paths should lead me in different ways. But sometimes they actually lead to the same place. And of course this one is a dead end, because why would it not be? So I guess we're headed the other way then. No choice in that matter. Or maybe we can rest here for a bit. Yeah, let's do that. And yeah. Cast Lumos. Cool. Alright then. Feel like I can spare using the shield spell until a later point in time. How long does it take for you to die then, sir? How long does it take? I'm guessing you didn't even... Yeah, you did actually get hit. It just takes some time for you to die. Quite a long time, actually. This is the kind of spell that you just hit people with and run, essentially. Where are the skellies?
Where are they?
Said Batman. I can hear skellies right there. The first objective can also be behind this door, by the way. Really, you little bitch. When she burned to death and said, "Thank you for coming out. I would have sought you out otherwise." I think these kinds of hexes are something that I should reserve for more difficult enemies. Spells like Joe Mama. Then again, it doesn't really make sense when you've got like these other spells to rely on. So maybe that's something that I could do better. Like when designing spells, I mean. Because I honestly don't find myself using them as much. Alright, so that leaves only this part unexplored, so let's save here and then we'll go there. Right then. Alright, let's go. We are headed to explore this dungeon in its entirety. Hopefully not. Hopefully we won't have to do that, but hope is, well, not something that you can always rely on. It's not a strategy. So we will ultimately do what we must. Okay, we're back there. Maybe time to cast invisibility, because why not? I see a mummy there, but that's definitely not the mummy that we're looking for. Better to cast it at your feet or when they're close by so that you can absorb the spell. 24 gold pieces and a holy candle. Right then. There's a part down there. There's a part up here. I guess we hadn't had a street first though. Prayer beads, scarab, and icon. Hi. Like, I don't see myself utilizing the poison spell enough, is basically what I'm trying to say. Alright, so at least we found something worthwhile. I can exit out of that maze-like structure. Although, the quest objective might very well be... Oh, this is that rest area part, right. Hi. Yeah, this is like just literally just a rest area for you to rest in. Okay, the safe, sure. Okay, let's go. Let us head back to the critical part then and try and figure out where the mummy could be. That guy did late onset death, but yeah, at least he died. That's all I really wanted to see. Okay, so there's like a path to our left here that we can take. No, there isn't. There isn't. So there is a path to the left and a path to the right. So which path should we take first? Let's go for the one on the left because I can see a door there. It might be where the zombie's hiding. It might also lead us nowhere, but it just might be where the zombie's hiding. The map is too zoomed out. Okay, seems to be another path for us to follow. Let us follow it then. These should lead us to the lower levels of the same maze-like structure. Huh. I was about to say mess-like structure, but then I remembered, well, this is not really a mess, is it? Dwarven katana, sure, that's gonna sell for some. But the only reason I've actually cast... invisibility is to remain unmolested by the pesky little creatures here. Sometimes these spells tend to... I hear more skellies incoming. The rat has died, and I'm guessing that's because the skelly killed the rat. Let's go ahead and heal first. Holy hell, my healing spell is really good, if I say so myself. Yeah, I would like to actually save a new slot here. And I would like to just go ahead and yeah, place a beat down right here. Because we left that area unexplored and I do not really want to leave any stone unturned in case we struggle with finding the damn zombie later. But yeah, this typically does lead somewhere as well. These paths right here. This place smells strongly of death, why wouldn't it? Of course it would. Of course it would. Alright, we're headed through this little section right here. There's a door here as well. Recasting invisibility because I do not want to get stuck upon these insignificant creatures. So, seemingly we have actually covered this side, so maybe we can remove that. There's also the path to our left and path right in front of us. Let us head to the path right in front of us then. This one? Yeah, that one. Alright, this brings us to another crossroads. And that also leads to the same place, but we'll mark it just in case. I'm looking for stuff along the fringes where there can be hidden walls. Hi, mummy. This guy's dead. We haven't been down there yet. Not from the looks of it, no. So, do we want to go exploring down there? Because we have actually come here. Yeah, we have come here. Let us remove that. I mean, we exited from here and we took a right there. So let's, in fact, go there instead. Let's see what that place has to offer us. We'll head down there later. First, we'll continue the journey this way. And we'll, of course... Okay, we have incidentally covered this part as well. So that's why it doesn't really make sense for us to try to cover every single one of these doors, because if you're casually just walking around the rim, you more or less end up covering all these parts anyway. So with that being said, let us head over to this side. Some few of these doors along the rims can actually lead you to whatever you're looking for. I wish there was a way I could set the... There is a hidden door there that I missed. Let's go and explore with them. Yeah, so one of these hidden doors can occasionally contain what you're looking for. Have I been here before? Seemingly I have. This was one of the places that I'd neglected to go search before. So seemingly I have come here. So let us go ahead and remove that bead. What else? I mean, there's still that place right there, so yeah, let's go. Let's take the next right and explore that part. Straight. Then again, yeah, that'll just get us there. Fine, let us go ahead and explore it nonetheless, because why the hell not? I see something here that I've left unexplored for whatever reason. I wonder why I never decided to explore it to the fullest. Interesting. Oh, that's right near the entrance of the dungeon. Oh, alright, never mind. Okay, so yeah, removing this bead from here. Let me just go and save in case the game crashes. New slot. So, going towards the right takes me to one of those parts there, and that we have also incidentally explored. Like, we didn't mean to explore it, but we just did end up exploring it nonetheless. Except for this door here. It might actually have the zombie behind it. I'll try it one more time. Of course, spell effect failed, but I did not. I would not really have been able to unlock the door in either case. But sometimes it can just have treasure. You never know. Well, that's it. Just like a little box. Yeah, this is essentially what I was searching for in this module here. Alright, so what else have we not explored yet? We have seemingly explored these lower levels to the fullest. We don't seem to have left anything unexplored here, unless I forgot to put on a bead or something, which we will confirm later on in case we cannot manage to find our way through this mess. Now, we have two choices here. We can either go here and explore whatever's down there, or we can explore the upper sections. I propose we actually explore this first. So how do I get down there again? I head up to the one on my left, take another left, and then a right. Yes, right here. Oops. Yeah, so we go through the store and then we'll come across something, a part of the dungeon that we have not explored yet. Right, so why did I not explore it then? Curious, quite curious indeed. Yeah, I do have to take a ride up there, right? Sometimes you just have to confirm multiple times before you can figure out the answer. The grind in these games is definitely intense, but once you figure it out, it's also very rewarding in a sense, just because of the fact that the grind is intense. If the grind wasn't intense, it would not feel as good. Alright, let's leave with a face with the enemies. I can hear somebody trying to smash something in. Saving here, and new start, because why not? I should rest on what I've learned about illusion, apparently. Okay, I can hear somebody trying to bash some kind of a door down. So, I guess what we're gonna do next is we're gonna go here. Like, exit the space and take a right, and then take a left. And head straight. Because we have not explored that area. And then there's that one over there, which we are yet to explore. I guess that tells us where we have explored and where we're yet to explore, I suppose. Oh, that's right near the starting, right. I keep forgetting. Why is there like a bead right here on top of this thing? Curious. Ah, okay. No, wait, what? Yeah, why is there like a bead right here? Placed in the middle of nowhere. Alright, let's explore this side then. Since we neglected to do it before, let us do it now. I can hear someone trying to bash down a door. It might just be the mummy. Yeah, we're supposed to take a left up there and keep straight. I can hear a mummy at least, so that I suppose is a good thing? I'm not certain. Okay, there's a mummy right there. Sort of gave me a jump scare, because I was not expecting it to be there. Okay. Have you forgotten how to open doors, sir? I suppose you have. So my shield saved me from the first loot that this guy dealt. Saving again. Because, well, I need to. Oh yeah, we're back. Got lost in thought for a second there. Anything here? I hear something. I don't know what it is, but I hear something. Somebody's trying to bash down a door, that's for certain. Mummy! Just 320 gold pieces, nothing else. I can hear a skelly as well. Quite certain it's the one behind this door right here. Yes, please, come out here. I eagerly obey you. Should I help you out though? Hi, let us begin this battle then. Okay, steel elven claymore, but picking that up will get me overweight. Formal tunic. What can I drop then? Oh yeah, I completely forgot about that one. The wand of fortitude, which I've got no idea how to use. Elven warhammer, what am I coveting here? The elven claymore? 7.5 kgs? 2 kgs, 7 kgs. Warhammer or Claymore, which one should we take then? Now, we do have a short sword here, but dropping that isn't really going to do much. Can't exactly drop our horse here, which weighs 800 goddamn kilos. Or this cart, which weighs nearly half a ton. Nothing here. Alright, I guess we're gonna just leave it behind then. No option. No other options there. Alright. Anything here? This looks like a cozy little room. Hi. I just took a screenshot of it. This door has been bashed open. Ah, that's because I bashed open this door. And we are at the entrance. Might as well drop some stuff to inside the wagon, I mean. These things and then all of this. Now I can actually go back and get that. Yeah, we closed this door on our own. So we have officially explored this side as well. It actually leads back upstairs. So with that having been done, let us remove both of these beads from here. Right, so we're gonna head this way instead. And we're gonna pick the elven claymore off the body of this skeleton. Right here. Cool. Now then, where are we supposed to head next? Well, that'll be upstairs, that's for certain. And then we're gonna have to go back to this labyrinth section, clear the upstairs area. And then we're gonna have to figure out which other area we have left unexplored so that we can find the damn mummy that we need to find. How many days do we have left? 2 days! 2 days, 12 hours, and 21 minutes. Doing quests like these is when you can really appreciate the recall spell. So where are we headed again? Oh yeah, we need to take that part down. That will not get us anywhere actually. So which path are we to take? I'm confused. Oh yeah, we just keep heading straight, go down there, and then that will lead us back to the start. That's where it came from. So I guess we head upstairs then. Seems to be the only thing that makes sense. And that takes us all the way back there. No, that's also the very starting of the game. How did we get here? Wait, I see a path. Alright, we head down here and then we take this route. Right. That makes much more sense. So is this like a corner that I've left? Yes, there is a corner left unexplored. That's probably where I was trying to place the door, but it got placed on this beacon instead. Alright, let us go ahead and explore that section as well then. We take the second exit on the left, the one that heads downstairs, and we keep straight. Right, and then we take a right once we're there. Hopefully. Time to recast invisibility. It keeps these pesky things off our ass. Excuse me. Time to go ahead and... yeah. I hear something there. Sounds like some sort of a... This part that we have not really explored either. There are like a few areas down here that we have not explored. So we'll just drop a bead right here. Pretty sure that once we get there, we'll be able to get there as well. But if not, we'll figure out a way to get there as well. I don't think there's anything there, but sure. A level more maybe? That's right, it's our level. Of course, the spell effect failed. Nope, just some loot, nothing else. Alright, I see a skelly. Which I suppose is a good sign. Kind shield has been working out in my favor. For now at least. Alright, this path here is blocked off, and there's only one path forward, so we'll just go ahead and see where that takes us. Apparently it takes us all the way back upstairs. Interesting. But I would like to confirm that before I do anything else. Let me go ahead and save first. New slot. You never know if an arena is gonna crash, so you need to keep saving like that. Otherwise, it can be bad news bears. Yes, so now that we're here and we have coincidentally explored that side as well, time to place like a few of these beads down there too. Or maybe remove that one because that is unwanted. So I will not explore the top yet because there's like this little portion down here that I've neglected to explore, so I'll just quickly go back down and explore that. And then we come back up here. Where was it, Romeo? Alright. If you say so, sir. If you say so. This should apparently also meet wherever this goes. Which is nowhere from the looks of it. Yeah. I remember placing that bead down there. Any other place that we have left to explore down here then? That place does indeed have a wall behind it. Alright, so now that we have confirmed that this... Oh, wait a minute, this does not lead down there. The path right behind us? It curves. Thought as much. Let's go! Exploration! Oh. It just abruptly ends like that. Never mind. Alright, so now that we've done all that, but where does this part go then? Sorry. Yeah. What is this, I wonder? Like, does it tell me how close I am to the exit? Or is it, does it actually tell me where the quest objective is? Interesting. Let's go seek that out just to confirm what that means. And where have we come out now? Should not have caused that, but it didn't do anything bad though, so I guess it's all right. Let me just put a bead down there. Interesting, somehow I'm back upstairs. I'm somehow back upstairs, and we have incidentally explored this path as well now. Is that... yeah, that place is a wall. Sorry about that. I was trying to erase that here. There we go. And we could go down there. Or, alternatively, we could just take a right here. You would tell me if there were any hidden doors, would you? Alright, let me just go ahead and put a bead down there. And hopefully we find the mummy right here. The one that I can hear, I mean. Fuck. Scared me. I swear, it was a little jump scare. I guess my speed is a little lacking because... well, this guy had some enchanted boots, so that's good, I suppose. I'll just go ahead and heal. Excuse me there. That dude came out of nowhere and scared me. I have the spell points to cast that spell, which is something that does terrify me truly. Ah, there you are. Just popping out of that place like that. Because why would you not be? 10 arrows and a steel shot bow. Too bad I don't actually use arrows. A helm, small scorpion stinger, holy candle, holy dagger, and a bell. It's a pity I can't really sell any of that stuff. I can hear more of these guys. It's like these guys get to come out before they can even open the door. A dwarven babble axe, interesting, that's gonna sell. I apparently do not have the spell points to cast a fireball, well now I do. Come on then. Oh, the door is locked, I see. Yeah, I'll let you guys bash down the door while I... deal with this guy here. Well, fuck. Skeletal warrior died at least, so that's good. Okay, so there's nothing here. At least we can rest though, because we just cleared this place out. Huh. My destruction, illusion, and blunt weapon, and I guess restoration. I forgot to check what it was. Like, I forgot what it was. Have improved, apparently. Knocks. Sometimes I forget that I didn't have knocks on. Alright, so have we covered this area in its entirety? I feel like we have. So I suppose at this point we'll be returning to the main dungeon then. Not any of these side routes here. So let me just refer to the map quickly. Yeah, we have incidentally explored this side here, so let me go in and remove that bead. We have incidentally also explored that end, so let me remove that bead. And incidentally, this side has also been explored, so I'll go ahead and remove that bead. That leaves only one side to explore, which is towards the right. So let's go to the right then. Right. This is the way, right? Yeah. Yeah. I feel like I've visited that place before, but it looks still looks lovely, doesn't it? Okay. Yeah, we have been here before. This is where I came in and I took a left instead of a right. So are there any paths that I have not taken here? The road not taken. How many of you have read that poem, I wonder? It's a pretty nice poem. Like, if you get the chance to, you should definitely read it. So I can see something all the way over here that we have left unexplored. But the question is, how the hell are we supposed to get to it? I do not see any other beads. Or notes with beads, for that matter. Yeah, that's like just a storage room, nothing there. The only place left to explore in this labyrinthine palace is all the way back there. All the way over here is where we need to go. So I guess what we need to do here is step through, get till there. Yeah, it's a pretty straight route, to be honest. There's not a lot of place to explore. Alright. We're going through the store here. We run along straight. I wonder how I missed that. Like, we can take like a shortcut from here. Like, we must have opened this door before and then we decided, you know what, we'll just explore it later. No, not this one. The next one over here. So see, missing doors like these is essentially what causes issues later on in the game, where you need to come back and re-explore places. If this game did not have any of these bees that are placing down, I would have been lost. I would have been stuck searching everywhere. Now, if I search through this place, I cannot find this damn mummy here, then, well, we're gonna have to essentially just... okay, there's like an entirely new section right here. So I guess, yeah, let's delete that first of all. Place a bead there and head that way. Since I'm still invisible because of the invisibility boost that I had equipped previously. I feel like I've been here before. I have not though. No, I have not. Right. This might just be where the mummy is, actually. You never know. We are going very deep. Do I have the wrappings in my inventory somehow? Ingredients? Magic items? No, I do not think so. Cool. Could be the mummy that we're looking for. Let's check. Could be the mummy wrappings that we're looking for. Actually. Yeah, right here. Cool. Good to see you, old friend. Good to see you after such a long time there. Leather gauntlet, not really necessary. Talisman doesn't really sell for money. So here's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna use, how do I put this? Divine Insight, right? Because I have the spell points for it. And I'm gonna identify these moves. 0 out of 10 identified, of course. I do not have any spell points left because why would I? So we're just gonna chill here until we get the spell points to teleport back, essentially. Or we could like rest here until we're fully healed, but I don't know how much time we have left. We've got like 2 days, 3 hours and 58 minutes left. We could probably rest here for a bit. Yeah. Resting by the fire in a random dungeon. Right, let us try this once again. And if it doesn't work, we'll let it be. Right, let's just get it identified for money instead. Now, yeah, let's just fuck about right here until we get our spell points back and we can get what we came for, essentially. Excuse me. Crazy how one of the last places that we decided to check actually had the first objective in it, but that's Daggerfall for you. So what I was about to say before is, if I search this, even this and the entirety of the remaining place that I haven't searched, and I cannot find the item, then I'm just gonna go ahead and use teleport quest marker. The cheat, I mean. Alright, teleport. Let us go ahead and teleport. I can make one set an anchor inside this closet. Right, Alabin Kingsman. Now that is a lovely piece of wrapping. Thanks awfully. I believe we agreed on 300 for some gold pieces, yes? Yes indeed. Right then. I'll take your gold for you. Thank you very much, sir. And I'll save the game here before the pre-quest thought. So saving sort of makes the game brighter for some reason. So the entire reason that I'm actually... Oh, yeah. Grinding apart from grinding up in the... How do I put this? Mage's Guild, grinding up the ranks in the Mage's Guild, is also because I want to level up my character. So with that being said, let us go and get another quest. If it's an easy quest, that'd be nice, but let's check nonetheless. Alright, I don't want to grab this guy, I just want to talk to him. Alright, let us get a quest. Do you like Astronaches, journeyman? I never have. Apparently some mage in another town has taken a liking to them. This mage has decided to start an army of them, in fact. You understand what I mean? This mage needs to be stopped before causing the real harm. Could you stop him? Okay, I think you mean to say Atronax there, not Astronaches. Right. You don't disappoint me, Strange, but this crazy mage no doubt knows of the plans to kill him, so you must be wary of traps. He must be guarded by other mages serving him, so expect quite a fight. Some of the students are veteran mages capable of destructive spells, I'd advise you to always have a defense shield up. Honestly, I've got invisibility, so I do not think that really matters. Yeah, the lunatic can be found in the mage's guild in Up Tower this time around. The mage will have his army ready in 8 days, so you must be done by then. This mage dead and burned. Burned. Alright. Interesting choice of words there. I've got just the spell for it. Fair luck to you, and may the great god Julianus watch over you and protect you. Julianus, eh? Okay, excuse me. So, yeah, the Revolt, apparently, this quest is called. Seems like a short quest, so alright, we'll do it. We'll do it. I'll cast teleport first, because I want to anchor myself to the ground, and let us go to Menevia then. Yeah, I actually sort of made this mistake when I made my character. I should have made sure that my character received damage from sunlight. That way he would always arrive at cities, inside cities during the night or after sundown, essentially. So that was a big oversight on my part. Uptar in Menevia province. Let's go. What's up, Dar? Nothing much. What's up with you? Alright, time to travel on foot horse. Yes, I'm now entering Uptar, which is... Blindboat by order of Belladorsa Hearthfield. No person showing signs of plague may enter or leave this town. Yes, this is essentially what happened last time as well. Why does that woman look so ghastly? My god, she looks like a ghostly being, doesn't she? There's smoke coming out of that chimney over there, my god! I never noticed that about this game. And what about the... yeah, there are no... because this is probably not a city seat, so there aren't any... banners on the walls. Alright, so there's something there which might just be the Mage's Guild. This looks like a temple, this looks like a virus guild, so this is most likely where we're headed. So, due east. Here we go. Move out of the way. Oh, okay. The sun has risen, it's just too cloudy for it to have any effect. This might be a difficult mission considering the fact that... I would not have any spell points upon getting inside. Alright, the guild is closed. So, I guess we loaded for us. What's... yeah, it's 11 o'clock right now. Actually, let me just save right here. Yeah. Right, the Mage is good. Now where the hell am I gonna find his students, I wonder? But at any rate... this is where I had to come, right? Uptar, current location, has sent me to kill a mad wizard at the Mage's Guild of Uptar. And I back at the guild in Menevia in 6 days, right? I'm just waiting to till I can charge up my shield right here. Let me go ahead and steal somebody's sweet roll for a minute here. Just to mask my presence while I can... yeah, that's better. And who am I looking for again? Doesn't really tell me. Edward Kingsmith. That guy's name is. I need to be a member of sufficient rank to access that apparently. We are exploring this place in its entirety. Wherever we can find, whatever we can find, we will go ahead and get it. Okay. We came out from there, let's head upstairs. This is the part where the game used to lag like anything. When I was playing the original DOS version of... are you the person that I'm supposed to talk to then? Nope. Fine to see that these guys are actually... that guy scared me. But these guys are... I can actually interact with these guys. But who were they supposed to kill again? I hope you're not the guy. The Mage's Guild member? I thought so. Glad to help. I could actually buy like a fortification spell from him. I do not think you're the person that I need to talk to, but... holy shit, look at this guy's portrait. What can I do for you? This guy looks even creepier in the portrait. Yeah, could you point me towards this certain guy that I'm looking to kill? Fellow members of the Mage's Guild have to stick together. Yeah, tell me about some people or... where is... General, maybe? Palace? Why would I want to go to the palace? That is certainly none of your concern, but leave me strange, but... well, then... What a hypocrite you are. Apparently you're not really the person that I'm supposed to kill either. I totally forgot his name and the quest log didn't exactly log it either. Has sent me to kill a mad wizard at the Mage Guild of Uptower. Uprising, apparently. I totally forgot the supposed wizard's name, though. But from the looks of it, I haven't faced a single shred of danger yet. Which I find surprisingly odd. Ah, this way. Right. Yeah. I can buy spells from you as well. Which is good to know, which is always good to know. That is a door which we will be exploring later. Or might as well explore it now. Pretty sure that's not the guy we're looking for, but who knows. Where are these Atronachs that were being talked about? Ah, there he is, I see. Jomama. 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 Now I was told to shock this guy, being the reason why I'm doing it this way. You have slain the mage. The mage's guild will be proud. Alright, pine branch. Can I really not carry that much? Hold up. Let me pull up the wagon and put these in. Yeah. Well, yeah, I can ask him to identify some of the stuff for me, can't I? Let's put these in as well, and let's put this in there as well, and yeah, we'll keep that in hand. Pine branch nodum, buckler, potion resist fire. Interesting. I was told to bone this guy, but I'm pretty sure this guy's like severely boned after all the Yomama jokes I made. Anyway, sorry, could not resist the opportunity. So, do you identify things still? No, you make spells. Let's add like a fortify spell. Add effect, fortify, and what the hell do I want to fortify? Intelligence? Intelligence will give me like... Let's bump this up to per 20 levels because that's how it works. Spell 188, what the hell? Oh! I was wondering, like, what the hell is going on here? Right, that's just the cost of the spell that I can buy. So, 3 levels, let's go with 3 levels. And it makes it to... Right, casting cost is 77, but it should last me like a long time, which I suppose is good. Plus 3 every 3 levels should not be a bad thing for beginners, I suppose. Although I think what I should do is fortify my speed instead. Because I do believe I've got enough willpower as is. I mean, the damage that my spells do sort of do rely on willpower, but... You know what, let's remove this and let's add an effect here. It'll be a fortify effect, of course. Yeah, fortify attribute, speed. Again, bumping it up to level 20 because duration does not work that way. And it does not seem to be increasing really. Yeah, 19, right here. Per 3 levels, cost is pretty nominal, but we're gonna fortify your speed by quite a big margin right here. Do I want it to be that this expensive? Sure, I don't see why not. This is like something that I'll be really using. So fortify attribute speed. I'll call this haste. And we'll just go ahead and... What icon should we give it, I wonder? Maybe this one? Seems like the kind of stuff I would like to give it. Like the kind of icon I would like to give it. Yeah, seems fine to be honest. Let's give it a second then. Green. Just to denote that it's our spell, something that we have made. Fire Beast. Yeah. Wait a minute. I can. What? Interesting. Of course, it can't be Fire Beast, but I can buy the spell then. We'll fuck around with willpower later because our willpower is pretty high already. So. Oh, I keep forgetting that I also have the talk of Far Silence. Like, our willpower is like literally 78, so. Yeah. Intelligence is also nothing to sneer at. Speed is a little lacking, so I do believe we can make some better adjustments. Our endurance is also quite high, actually. And our health is 130 points of health. That's nothing to laugh at, to be honest. Strength could use some work, but it's alright. Alright, our invisibility is fading. Although I don't really care much for it. Do you identify things, sir? No, you train people. Nothing in there. I do believe that the person who identifies stuff is upstairs. So we're probably gonna have to make another trip upstairs then. Alright, I do believe it was this guy, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, right here. Let us select this, get it identified. 223 gopis, what the hell? Right, info about it. Chain Boots of Far Silence. Well, I guess in combination with this, which is the more expensive one? We don't know. It isn't Ellis. It's 2290 gold, but I don't know how much this is. So we'll compare how much it costs. For now, let us wait a minute. What's going on here? Ah, that guy. Mordor Kingcroft. Alright, let us teleport back to the anchor. Right, sir. I have slain the mage for you, but I do not know why you would want me to do that. I do not see a single Atronach or any of his students, sir. At any rate, here we are. Ah, the great and evil mage is no longer raising all hell, and you are alive. You have accomplished your task, Strange Blood. The guild is forever in your debt. Enjoy your 286 gold pieces, Strange Blood. You deserve every bit of it, my friend. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Okay, I'm gonna remove that to the inventory as well. Alright, let's go ahead and save the game. We should be getting a promotion now. Allow me to be the first to offer my unreserved congratulations on your glorious ascension to the up the slippery hierarchy that is the Mage's Guild. Now that I've achieved the rank of Evoker, you have access to the guild library. I can remember when I was first deemed worthy of such an honor. My eyes did not leave printed page for 3 whole days. My advice is to take advantage of this as soon as possible. Once again, jolly good show, Strange Bird. I am honored, kind quester. Alright, so that's what I really wanted to do with this. What I really wanted to do with this video. But we still haven't learned the location of that place, or, you know, how do I put this, leveled up. It's still stuck at 93%. To be fair, I didn't really make much of it either. Vampires of the Illiac Bay, the big children, fragment on Arteim. Holidays of the Illiac Bay, King Edward Part 3, Real Berenzi Part 6, that's a nice collection. Confessions of a Thief. Anything good here? Something that. Origin of the Mage's Guild, the Healer's Tale. Yeah. Nothing that'll raise our skills here. These are all etiquette with rulers. Oh. Nothing that's actually going to raise our skills, to be honest. Lus Animal God, or Eus. I don't know what it's called. It's certainly something. Of the light and the dark, of on lycanthropy. Mysticism, maybe? The unfathomable voyage. Mysticism is the school of magic least understood by the magical community, most difficult to explain to novices mages, or novice mages. And spell effects are commonly ascribed to the school of mysticism are widely disparate as soul trap, the creation of a cell for the victim's spirit after death, to silence, the extinction of sound, but these effects are simply that, effects. The sorcery behind them is veiled in a mystery that may go back to the older civilizations of Tamriel and beyond. Interesting. I actually like to read the books of these, games, of the Elder Scrolls games, when I get the time to read them. I don't like to read them in-game, but I do like to head over to the unofficial Elder Scrolls pages and read them there. That took us no time whatsoever coming out. It's probably because the world outside had already been looted. You scared me. Where were you the first time I looked right? Anyway, that was that for this video. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be headed to, well, what's it called? The Illicen Hills, to essentially complete some quests for the Order of Arkay and hopefully level up. And once we do level up, we will be completing Cassandra's quest. So this edition of Daggerfall actually has been patched. So yeah, this edition of Daggerfall has been patched. So this includes one of those things that you're supposed to be able to do in that quest, but which was never really implemented in the original game. You don't necessarily have to kill Cassandra's brother, but we'll get to that when we get to the quest. So, yeah, until next time, take care, fare thee well, fellow Oathlings.